Hello friend. After a wait of more than 2 years, Debian has just released a new version called Trixie. With this new version, that is Debian 13, you will now get an updated kernel, newer versions of desktop environments, and lots more. So, if you are someone who want to ditch Windows because Microsoft is killing Windows 10 support, then Debian can be a perfect option for you. Because Debian is known for its rock-solid stability, community support, and most importantly, you can keep using your computer system without any issue. Therefore, in today's video, I will give you a complete step-by-step guide on how to install Debian 13 properly. So, without further ado, let's begin. Our first step is to download the Debian 13 installation ISO. So let's open a web browser and in the address bar type debian.org and hit enter. Now when you are on the Debian homepage, all you have to do is click here in the download button and it will download a net installation image of Debian 13. Or else you can go to the other downloads page and from here you can download a larger complete installation image. The difference in these two methods is that if you download the ISO from the homepage, you will end up with a smaller net install image, meaning you will need a fast and stable internet connection for the installation process. Whereas if you download the complete installation image, you will have a full installer, and with that, you will be able to install Debian even if you do not have an internet connection. And finally, if you are someone who have the first try then buy mentality, then you can also go with the third option and choose your preferred live environment like GNOME, KDE or XFCE and try Debian desktop before installing it on a physical hardware. But for a normal installation, I will prefer the complete installation image option. So let's download it and then we will continue. Okay, now that the download is complete, all we have to do is create a bootable USB drive. You can use programs like Rufus or Belenature, but I prefer Ventoy because it is much more functional. So I will go with that. Then once you boot into the USB drive, you will be greeted with this screen and our installation process will start here. You can see that there are lots of options here, but for an easy experience, you must select the first option, which is graphical installer. In the next step, you have to select a language. You can choose your preferred language from this list. Mine is English, so I will go with that. Then you have to select a location from this list. It means the country where you live in. Mine is India, so I will select that. Next is the keyboard configuration. I have an English layout keyboard, so for me, American English is okay. You can choose your preferred language. Okay, now here it is automatically detecting the hardware and the networking configuration. Next, we have to enter a host name. By default, it is always Debian, which is perfect for me. But you can change it if you want. It is up to you. But default is okay for most of the time, so I will continue with that. Next, it is asking for a domain name, which is not necessary, therefore you can leave it blank. Then you have to create your root password. I will use a simple one because I am doing this just for a demonstration purpose. But you must use a strong root password. In this next step, you have to create a new user account. The reason behind this is that using a root account for everyday tasks is not advisable for security reasons. You can use your own name or anything that relates to you. I will go with NixNexus and continue. Username for the account looks good, so let's continue again. Okay, here you have to create a password for your new user account, which you have just created. You can use the same password as your root account, but if someone else is also going to use your system, then it is better to use a different password. I will go with the simple one just like before. Now it is detecting my storage drives and partitions. Then this is where you have to do the disk partitions. For beginners, I will only recommend the first option, that is guided use entire disk. Whereas if you are thinking of dual booting, then you must go with the manual option. But for now, we will continue with the guided partition. First thing you have to do is select your disk drive. One thing you must note here, in my case, here it is showing /dev/vda because I am using a virtual machine. But in case of a real machine, it will show /sda or in some cases /hda instead of vda. But all of them functions the same. So I will select my vda disk and continue. Next, there are three options. The first option, which is all files in one partition, is generally recommended for everyone. But if you are someone who have already used Linux in the past and have a habit of distro hopping, then you must go with the second option, which is separate/home partition. But in my opinion, the second and the third option is way overkill for any beginner. So I will skip them for now. Okay. Now you can see here that the image has automatically created two partitions. First one is our boot partition and the second one is for swap partition, which acts as a secondary RAM in Linux systems. So you can go ahead with the option which is finish partitioning and write changes to disk and then select yes. And now it will format the disk and start installing the base system for us. Let's speed up this process and see what comes next. Okay, this section is not that important. Here it is basically asking if you have any additional media disk or not. Those who have installed Debian back in the days of CDs and DVDs, they will know that Debian used to come in a pack of 2 CD disks. But now you can skip this one. So, no. Next. Here it is asking if you want to install the package versions which are available on the disk or you want to update them. So I will select yes because updated packages are always better. Then here it is asking you to select a package download mirror. Mine is India. You must select your location. But if you could not find your location, you can also choose any place which is closer to your actual location. Next, in this section, you have to select your archive mirror. In my case, I have always found that the default one performs the best, so I will go with that. Proxy is not necessary for ordinary users, so you can leave it blank and continue. And now it will start updating and installing the available packages. So we will let it do its thing and come back when it's done. Okay. Package update is done and now it is asking you if you want to take part in their popularity contest survey or not. Basically what it means is that it will collect some statistics from your system and send them back to the Debian developers. It will help them to make Debian better in future. I always select yes because I want to support this open source project. But you can also select no as well if you do not like giving your information to others. It is your choice. So next. Okay, now it is running the task cell manager and here we have something interesting. By default, the ISO image has selected 3 options for you: Debian desktop environment, GNOME and standard system utilities. And the most important thing to remember here is that you must never unselect the standard system utilities. Otherwise, your system will be non-functional. If you wish to use Debian as a lightweight server in a CLI and TTY mode, you can unselect the Debian desktop environment and GNOME options. But if you want to use Debian with a graphical user interface, then you must select the Debian desktop environment and one from these 8 desktop environment options. You can also select more than one desktop environment, but remember it will consume more disk space. You can also install a web server and an SSH server if you need. But the default settings are okay for me. So I will hit next and let it install the whole system for me. And if you remember, we are using a complete installation ISO. So it will not take very long. Okay, now the last thing we have to do is install the grub bootloader. So let's continue. Here you have to select your primary disk. In my case, the primary drive here is /dev/vda, but yours could be dev/sda or /hda, as I mentioned earlier. So let's select and continue. And finally, our installation is complete. So let's reboot the system and see what we get with the new Debian 13. Just like Debian 12, we are greeted with the GDM Login Manager. And you can see the user ID is automatically captured. So let me enter my user password. And here we are in a newly installed Debian Trixie. So let's check our system details for once. For that, we have to go to the settings, then systems, then about, and system details. Here you can see our operating system is Debian 13 Trixie. Our desktop environment is GNOME 48 and we are using Wayland. And finally, our kernel version is 6.12, which is a long-term support kernel. So there you have it. I hope this video will make your Debian 13 installation journey much easier. But if you still have any question or confusion, feel free to reach me in the comment section below. And if you have found this guide helpful, do not forget to subscribe to the channel because your help and support encourages me on keep making contents like this. So, see you in the next video. Until then, keep learning and keep using Linux.